teacher could get fired. Michael Copeland's daughter was in the classroom when the incident happened. He joins us along with his daughter, Maggie. Welcome to both you, Michael and Maggie. Nice to see you.
Thank you very much.
Maggie, let me start with you since you were in the classroom. Tell me what you saw. What happened?
Well, he was teaching us about symbols, and he gave us examples such as the cross symbolizing Christianity. And then he took the flag, and he said that it was just a symbol of America, and just with the cloth with colors on it. And then he threw it on the ground and stomped on it.
What was the reaction, Maggie, of the students in the classroom? Just watching or anyone saying anything to them?
Yeah, we were all very shocked. And he even made a comment afterwards. He said that at least he reacted better than his other class, that he had girls scream in other class.
Is he a teacher that is typically well-liked by the students?
By some of them. I wouldn't say by all of them, though.
Michael, how did you find out about this?
Well, we're getting ready to have dinner one night, and Maggie made a comment about, like, Mr. Compton stepping on the American flag, and I said, what do you mean? And she said, yeah, he stepped on the flag. And I said, when? And she said, I didn't tell you about this. I said, no. And I said, start from the beginning. Tell me exactly what happened. And so she tells me the story, just like she said, as far as like what he did and what happened. And I said, well, you know, what was the whole point of this? I mean, was there something he was trying to teach? And she said, no, I really don't remember anything. I said, was he just get overexcited in the moment of saying something? She said, oh, no, he did this to the two of his other classes.
What did you do then, Michael? Did you contact anybody? You call the teacher and say, what's up with this?
Well, what I did first is I was very, very upset. I mean, I was just really to the point of shaking when she first told me this. So I just did not want to overreact with that at the very beginning. So I went through the course of the rest of the week and I just asked her the same questions over. What happened again? Tell me again. Because I wanted to make sure that this was absolutely certain. She said, oh, yes, this happened. So on Thursday morning, I found out all about it on Monday night. Thursday morning, I sent an email to the district superintendent. I copied the members of the school board for electing into office, as well as the local leaders for the WIS. And also sent a copy of it to various groups like my old Rotary Club and some Boy Scout units that I'm involved with. And I sent the story about what happened and what she had told me. And I sent that, and the very first person that responded was a superintendent. And he said that he was not aware of this. This is the first he's heard of it, and that he would immediately investigate this. And he also added that he, too, was a veteran, and that he did not agree with what may have happened. The very next morning, on Friday morning, I received an email from him stating that on the initial investigation that he has suspended the teacher or placed him on administrative leave, and that a further investigation is underway.
Maggie, did the teacher ever come back like the next day or something and say anything about it at all?
No, he never mentioned